Hi, I'm Randy Efron from Skylattice Property Capital. I'm a former CPA, and I spent over a decade in New York City investing capital into commercial real estate on behalf of the private equity and Wall Street lending firms that I worked for. Now, I leverage that experience and those relationships to help you raise capital for your real estate deals. In today's episode, I am going to discuss the third key party that comprises the operation of a hotel. The asset manager. What does an asset manager do? In simple terms, the asset manager is responsible for executing the business plan for the hotel. Since the operation of the hotel affects the value of the real estate, the operation is a very important part of the business plan for the hotel. As a result, one of the asset manager's key responsibilities is to oversee the hotel manager. How does the asset manager oversee the hotel manager? Well, every asset manager has its own style, but some of the common methods include the following. Number one, weekly calls with the hotel management company that may include an executive from the management company's corporate office, the hotel's general manager, the director of sales, the hotel's controller, and a revenue manager. Number two, monthly visits to the hotel. Number three, formal mid-year review meetings. Number four, formal annual budget meetings. Additionally, each month, the management company usually submits a report to ownership that includes a wealth of information on the hotel's prior month's performance. It is the asset manager's responsibility to review those reports and analyze the information to determine if operational changes are warranted. In addition to overseeing the hotel manager, the asset manager is also responsible for functioning as a liaison between the hotel owner, the franchisor, the manager, investors, and lenders. In doing so, the asset manager has multiple responsibilities that fall outside of the actual operation of the hotel, such as financial reporting to lenders and investors. The asset manager could be employed by the owner of the hotel, or they could be an outside consultant. So there you have it. Between my prior videos and this video, you now know the three key parties that comprise the operation of a hotel, excluding the parties that are on site every day. Now, keep in mind that the operation of a hotel requires many employees that are very important to the hotel's operation. Some of those employees include the general manager, the controller, and the director of sales, among many others. My episodes thus far were intended to cover the three key parties that comprise the operation of the hotel, excluding those individuals that are on site every day. In future episodes, I will go into greater detail on the staffing within the hotels. In the interim, please click subscribe, like, or follow if you would like to stay informed about new episodes, or send me an email at randy.efron@skylattice.com if you need help refinancing your loans, raising debt or equity capital for your deals, or would simply just like to leverage your time better without incurring any overhead. Thanks, and I'll see you next time.